watching anywhere around the world, including a warm bed on this cold morning. We arrive at the threshold of the year. On one hand, this is the time of the year that occasions looking backwards. There are retrospectives of the year that was, recaps of the major news stories and events of the past year, retrospectives remembering the famous and newsworthy people who died in the past year. There are lists and lists and more lists ranking the best movies and best music and best books, etc. And every year when I read those lists, I feel more out of touch. Like I've heard of fewer of them. In our own lives, this time of the year may occasion looking backwards as well. To spend time remembering the year that was, whether at a personal level or at the larger societal, political level in which we live. This can be a time of the year for taking stock, for spending time reflecting, reviewing, and remembering. I invite you to take a moment and think back on this year that has passed. What were those moments from this past year that brought you joy, gladness, satisfaction or accomplishment? What were the moments from this past year that brought you pain and hurt? What were your regrets, your disappointments, your struggles? What do you most want to bring with you into this new year? And what do you want to leave behind? What do you want to let go of? We arrive at the threshold of the year. And on the other hand, this is also the time of the year that occasions looking forward. The headlines are full of stories with big and bold predictions about the coming year, things to look forward to or look out for. And we can do that looking forward in our own lives as well. We can make resolutions for how we hope to be, what we hope to achieve and accomplish in the coming year. We can take stock, deciding what we would like to change, what we'd like to let go of, what we can look forward to. This is the time of year when many of us take time to imagine, to plot, to plan, even to scheme new ventures and adventures. So take that moment as well to reflect. What hopes do you carry with you into this coming year? What resolutions? What commitments? What do you await with eagerness? What do you dread? Take a moment and face fully into the future. And so we arrive at the threshold of the year. I titled my sermon this morning, my remarks, Janus is a two-faced god. In Roman religion, Janus is the god of thresholds and boundaries, of opening and closing, of passages, of endings and beginnings. In case you may be wondering, the month of January is actually named for the god Janus. It is Janus's month. In Roman religion, Janus is depicted as having two faces. Elizabeth in the church office included an image of Janus's two-facedness on the front cover of your order of service. So you can actually see the god looking forward and backward. Janus is the god of the threshold, standing at the threshold with one face looking backward into the past and one face looking forward into the future. In one legend, Janus provides sanctuary to the god Saturn, who is fleeing from Jupiter, and and Saturn bestows upon Janus the ability, the divine ability, to see both the future and the past simultaneously. If you'll allow me a silly digression this morning, you don't really have a choice. I'm going to make a silly digression. I do want to recognize that more than one person this week, Glenn was one person, but more than one person, after seeing the title of my sermon, sent me that strange news story from earlier this week, from about 4 days ago, about a cat named Betty B, born in South Africa, and this cat was born with a rare craniofacial disorder that left it Janus-faced. That is, it has two faces, like two sets of eyes, two noses, and two mouths. And this is kind of this rare disorder, but there are cats that live full lives with two faces. And one person, it wasn't Glenn, even sent me the encouragement saying, "I hope you'll mention this in your sermon. Preach about the cat." And I'm really not sure that my theological training prepared me for that challenge. I mean, what am I supposed to say about this cat? And so I would say just that if you have thoughts about the theological significance of the cat with two faces, please discuss that with me after the service. Probably the most interesting story, what can compete with a two-faced cat? But the most interesting story I found related to Janus was about the traditions at the temple to Janus in Rome, which has two sets of doors on either side of the temple and the statue of the god inside. According to Roman custom, during times of war, the doors to the temple were left open, and the doors would only be closed during times of peace. Now, Rome was an empire, and from what I've read, the doors to the temple were pretty much open throughout pretty much the entirety of the Roman Empire. Since the Roman Empire was at war constantly, the doors to the temple were open pretty permanently, and were only closed when a Roman emperor had them closed for propaganda purposes, like the 2,000 year ago equivalent of mission accomplished. Now, if you know me at all, you know that I am in no way a fan of the war-making ways of empire. They're immoral and destructive, and I'm totally stretching with this interpretation, but there's something to be said. I think there's something to be said for times of conflict and crisis and emergency also being times when the past and the future can be seen. What I guess I'm trying to say is what Valerie Carr so eloquently said a little while back, that the darkness that our lives may be in is not necessarily the darkness of the tomb, but could be, she says, the darkness of the womb, as something new is being birthed into being, not without struggle, not without pain, not without fear, and not without suffering. But she says the door stands open in times of crisis. That's probably not what the Romans meant when they opened the doors, but I think there's something in that image of the doors standing open in times of crisis. Janus, I went on to discover in my research, is far from the only mythological figure to model this practice of simultaneously looking forwards and backwards. In West Africa, in what is present-day Ghana, the Akan people tell stories about the Sankofa bird. The Sankofa bird, see if you can imagine this, the Sankofa bird flies forward while looking backward and while carrying the egg of the future in its mouth. I'll say that again. The Sankofa bird flies forward while looking backwards and while carrying the egg of the future in its mouth. word Sankofa literally translates as, it is not taboo to go back to fetch what you forgot. It's not taboo to go back to fetch what you forgot. Janus is a two-faced god who looks towards the past and towards the future simultaneously. The Sankofa bird flies forward while looking backwards, all the while carrying the egg of the future in its beak. And what about us mere mortals? The truth is, we have to learn to do both as well. We have to look back into the past and forward into the future simultaneously. Here at the new year, we must look back from whence we've come and forward into the future that beckons, not one to the exclusion of the other. A Unitarian Universalist minister named Ellen Cooper Davis wrote what I think are some helpful words about how to look back and how to look forward, and I'd like to share her words with you. She writes, look forward, but do not look forward with resignation. All looking into the future is merely speculative. Look forward with hope and vision. Dare to imagine what it would be like to align value with action, to live out of truth and beauty and goodness. Listen for what calls to you and what feels life-affirming and expansive. Take small steps and savor what you learn and encounter along the way. And look backward, but do not look backward with regret or longing. All looking into the past is illusory in its own way. We've been to those places already, and we cannot change the stories that emerge there. Look back with gratitude and equanimity. Allow your life, your stories, and your experiences to speak to you. You need not judge them or yourself. All of our experiences, all of our days change us. We are not the people we have been before, so have compassion for your earlier selves rather than harshness. Notice which stories and experiences speak to you most persistently. Allow the steps from your past to help to shape and inform the steps of your future. It is you and here and now that is always the essential link between the two. Those reflections were from Ellen Cooper Davis. So, of course, even though we come to the threshold of the year, we don't have the luxury of spending all of our time looking back into the past or imagining the future. There is a sense in which we need to live in the present. But I would ask us, as we cross this threshold into a new year, that we remember and that we learn from the wisdom of the Sankofa bird and from the wisdom of Janus, the two-faced god. And the wisdom, I think, that they have to offer, at least how I interpret the wisdom that they have to offer, is that we do not live just for ourselves in the present, but that we live with a constant accountability both to the past and to the future. We are to live in such a way that includes and that balances honoring our ancestors while also being accountable to the children of our children. We are to live in such a way that includes and that balances both honoring our ancestors while being accountable to the children of our children. To live in that threshold, to stand at that threshold, is to stand at that place, at that junction that connects past with present, with future. And so I ask you to consider what it would be like amidst the decisions that you make, amidst the plans, amidst your discernment. And the days and weeks and year before us. To live and to choose. To live and to choose. According to what will bless the children of our children, to live with that eye towards the future, and as well to live to that eye towards our past, to ask of our ancestors, of those who come before who we seek to learn from, to live and to choose in a way that honors that as well.